Welcome back to The Legend of Heroes, Trails in the Sky. In the last part, we did a lot of stuff.
Yeah,
like what kind of
that,
stuff?
We finished that tournament thing, and then there was story.
It was a lot of story, walking around Grancil Castle. We met up with a bunch of old characters.
And some dickhead cockblocked Olivier from joining the dinner party.
Yeah. Mueller Vander.
Yeah, some dickhead.
Yeah.
I agree.
I'm
his
sure
name
he,
is
we
also,
won't see him ever again.
His name is also some dickhead, in my opinion.
Okay. Sure. Oh, we also met up with Hilda, the head maid of the castle. And so now we have to wait for after the dinner party to, you know, do anything.
Feel bad for Olivier. Justice for Olivier.
Why? Because he's not allowed to be with high-ranking people?
Yeah.
Yes.
And cause possibly an international incident?
Listen, he's not that misbehaved.
Oh no, he is. He very much is. There's a reason why I paid Mueller to escort him off the premise. Also, so we wouldn't have a team of four anymore, because I thought you guys were getting complacent with that.
Why? Why do you hate fun?
Well, I hate you having fun.
No, you just hate fun in general.
Fun's not allowed. I'm the fun police, and you're all under arrest. For having fun. Anyway, it's time to go eat, so I'll let you have fun eating. How's that sound?
Okay, fine.
Except all we're gonna eat is silverware. Do you think Estelle knows the word hors d'oeuvres?
Isn't it pronounced our d'oeuvres?
No. It's.
I rest my case.
It is not pronounced that at all.
I don't know. Let's hit up Google real quick.
Okay,
and
excuse me. It's horse Dover.
Horse Dover?
It's a little closer, yeah. When in Liberal, do as Liberalians do.
What does that mean?
When in Vegas? That means eat with forks and knives as opposed to chopsticks. In this specific context.
Probably getting drunk or something.
I hope he is. Then he probably won't talk to us. Oh boy. It's him.
I don't know what Philip gets paid, but he doesn't get paid enough.
I was gonna say, he probably doesn't. He probably deserves the National Treasury, for every hour he deals with Duke Dunnan.
Yeah.
Why?
Also, it's Onion Head.
Why is it that, like, Duke Dunnan, his haircut, and his, like, his style just reeks of, I shower myself in Axe body spray.
Ugh.
Honestly, probably does.
Like, it's probably a national crime.
He should be under arrest for, like, treason or something.
You know the scene in Shrek 2 when Shrek turns himself into a human and he's like, you know, a quote-unquote Prince Charming?
Mm-hmm.
Duke Dunnan looks like that if he was fugly.
Oh, God.
How dare you badmouth Shrek by using him as a comparison to this man?
I was gonna say, I think that, in a way, wait, no.
Alright, no. I apologize to Shrek. But to be fair, say, like Shrek, but fugly.
Yeah, I was gonna say, you were complimenting Shrek, weren't you?
Yeah.
He was saying he was a step above this, but I was also saying, how dare you
compare
Shrek as a baseline this man in any form.
God, maybe if his haircut didn't suck, I wouldn't like hate him so much.
Maybe if he had more of a facial hair. Looks
his,
like he like
his facial
like
hair makes
Elmer
it even
glued.
Worse.
Yeah, he Elmer glued that
he,
those three hair strings to his face. Oh shit! He has an important announcement.
Aside from the one guy that looks a lot like Professor Banner, Duke Dunnan is the character that most looks like he belongs in Yu-Gi-Oh! GX.
Oh, you mean Professor Alba?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The guy that looks like Professor Banner.
Yeah. I just have to remind everyone
that he does have a name.
He has a name. That's
and not just Professor Banner.
But you know who doesn't have a name? Saki Konishi's brother.
God damn it.
Who? We're not even doing that LP, so I'm not even paid to know who that is.
You're not paid at all.
Oh. Well, there's a higher res image of Duke Dunnan for everyone.
Ew. God.
I do not want that. I did not ask for it.
The fucking bowl cut. The bowl cut with the undercut.
It's so bad.
So bad.
Oh, yeah. Something important's being talked about on screen. And we might want to say something real quick. Apparently the Queen is going to turn the shit over to Duke Dunnan.
Ew.
No. Please.
This is a horrible idea.
Yeah, and it's going to finally become public that this is the chain of actions is going to happen.
If Duke Dunnan's hair was poofier, he would be like some rejected distant relative of Weevil Underwood.
He would play a bug deck in a trading card game. I wouldn't. Mayor Maybell has a point. Why can't the next queen or king be voted on?
Silly kids. The king and queen are a part of a monarchy. Monarchies aren't democracies.
Not yet, anyway. Distantly cocks gun. Oh yeah, so basically, Colonel Richard's plan is let the leaders know first, that way when it becomes public knowledge, there's already a game plan amongst, like, officials from each region. So that's why they're letting people know that that's what's happening, that Duke Dunnan's going to take over.
But why Duke Dunnan?
Because he's far more easily to manipulate than this Princess Claudia figure that we've been told about. You know, because he's dumb.
Interesting. So in other words, he's just kind of a necessary evil.
Yes. If Colonel Richard wants to do whatever his whole plot thing is, then he has to have something, he has to have a puppet as head of state, and what's easier as a puppet than Duke Dunnan? Maybe an actual puppet, but, you know, Duke Dunnan's pretty much there. Oh, and one other thing, they are going to go arrange a marriage for Princess Claudia, somewhere and call it good. Get her out of the way. Yes, Zane, what would you like to ask?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
I don't know.
Yeah. I don't understand anything that's happening.
Yeah. I was gonna say, this is starting to go slightly over my head.
Guys, why is the Onion talking?
Because he has bad things that are about to happen. And we have to go deal with that. Does that simplify everything?
Yeah.
Okay.
Onions are evil. Got it. I knew that already, though. But thank you.
But the food was amazing.
Listen, food doesn't discriminate between good and evil.
Food just is.
It just is.
Waha?
Oh yeah, it's getting a little stuffy in here. Sorry, Zane. We're gonna go, hold hands in the hallway?
What?
Landon.
Huh?
We can't do that on YouTube.
Get banned.
No, that's what we're just telling Zane that's what we're doing.
Okay, but we cannot show the hand holding.
Okay,
just to be clear,
we're not gonna actually. No, they need to go meet up with Hilda. Because
listen,
now we're after the. Okay, yes,
I'm just listening. Saying.
Mm-hmm. Are we? Am I allowed to show when Joshua is just? Over, or when Estelle's sprite is over top Joshua's sprite, and their hands are in the same place?
Yes.
I mean, that's hand-holding. That's not their fault.
Oh.
Okay.
It's like...
So anyway, whoa. Oh.
Man's voice.
Man's voice? Who's man's?
Oh, goddammit.
It's Colonel Richard again. Man, this guy, like, wants to be around us for some reason. Oh. Jack, you're gonna love the end of this app. That's all I have to say.
Okay.
Cloud, you're gonna hate the end of this app.
I am?
Yes. I'm sorry. I'm sorry I have to, say that. But anyway... Onion Head here wants to, I don't know, talk to us in private, so if the Fox Lady would, leave.
Yes, sir. Grr.
Bye, loser.
Murger grr.
Yeah, if there's anyone to murger grr,
it's her.
It's her. This way.
Whoosh.
I guess we're also going to be delayed for our meeting. Whoops. Meanwhile, in the very next scene, hey guys, do you want a little bit of backstory on one Daddy Cassius Brightius?
Ooh,
as a treat?
As a small treat.
Hell yeah.
Yes. Because Colonel Richard served under him while Cassius Bright was in the military.
Hmm.
So he's going to tell us a little bit about that time. But I'm not going to show you him on screen.
Oh. So, at least we're talking about him.
Yes. That's all you get. Will he show up before the end of the game? We'll find out within the next,
probably not, but maybe briefly.
You know, my hands are tied on this.
I mean...
He bought the extended vacation package, okay?
You are definitely with tied hands because you didn't make this game.
Uh-huh. Also because he bought the extended vacation package. He used promo code Stooges on his AAA order for the vacation package in Erebonia. He got 0% off. I thought we'd keep that running joke one more time, because now it's dead.
But now, if you go to Raycon and you type Stooges, you'll get 0% off your order of Raycons.
See? The joke's dead, guys.
That didn't take long.
When he comes back, he's in so much trouble.
Then he's just not going to come back. Yeah.
That's why he bought the extended vacation package. He knew that one Estelle Bright would beat him within an inch of his life.
Yes.
And probably my life, too.
His own daughter, who is a far less experienced bracer.
She's not actually going to do anything. She's just going to be really pouty and angry around him all the time.
And that's, I mean, that's almost as bad, if not worse.
So much trouble.
Regrets? What would you regret?
What, are you going to die?
Maybe. Who knows? Oh, okay. Bye, dude.
I mean, usually whenever someone is like, oh, I have no regrets, I'm going to spill everything to you, it usually foreshadows that something bad is going to happen to them.
Well. I don't know. I did my best to remove the memory of the rest of the game. So this is new to me. Just like you guys.
Probably.
Joshua is the mistrustful kind.
A little bit. And yet, he's more accepting of Olivier than Estelle is.
It's probably because he's so, you know, untrusting to most people that he knows he can trust him.
There you go.
Yeah. All right, enough fooling around.
Let's save Yukiko.
Oh, wait.
Well, I think the thing is that so Joshua thinks with his brain. But Estelle just kind of thinks with her gut. And
yeah.
And the gut says, Olivier is smelly.
Meanwhile, Joshua,
I bet he
like,
smells wonderful. Excuse you, Estelle.
Meanwhile, Joshua's like, this guy's weird, but he's ultimately harmless.
What's up, Hilda?
We're sorry we made you wait.
We're sorry that you look like you haven't had sleep in weeks.
There is a couch right there. You could have taken a nap.
Go take
please
a nap,
sleep.
Please.
Please get rested.
Like a 16-hour nap.
In fact, no one will care. Like, we'll look the other way if you just want to sleep for 3 days.
Yeah. In fact, if you just want to spend that time binge-watching the Legend of Heroes Trails in the Sky Let's Play...
By Gaming
Stooges. Gaming
Stooges.
Yeah. By all means. And if you want to leave a comment on every single video and a like, just, you know, help the YouTube algorithm, it'd be perfectly fine by us.
As long as you make sure that on one of those videos you click that little bell icon, so that way there, you'll get notified of our newer uploads as well.
Yeah, like this one, when this one goes up.
Imagine she's watching a part that has herself in it. She's like, hey, wait, that's me. It's all like Twilight Zone shit.
The Twilight Zone, but the story is just you have to watch a Let's Play of your entire life. like some douchebag on YouTube just doing commentary over your entire life.
That's awful. In order to get to the Queen, we're gonna have Estelle dress up.
Makes sense.
In a maid outfit. So,
what?
That's cool. Huh?
What?
We're gonna have Estelle dress up in a maid outfit to fool the guards in front of...
Cloud has logged into the chat.
What'd you say, Jack?
Has logged into the chat.
Cloud's logged into the chat.
Oh, yeah. Joshua...
Oh, God! Is he gonna get dressed like he did during the... Yup. Oh, God.
Cloud has exited the chat.
I've exited the chat. I'm keeping
how actually sad he is.
I'm keeping one eye on the chat from around the corner.
Come on, help us out here.
She's right, though.
You do look very pretty.
Oh. Poor Joshua.
He's so defeated.
It seems like democracy wins in the end, folks. Bye, Joshua.
So, let me get this straight. No Estelle in a maid outfit, and Joshua's gonna cross-dress again.
No, both of them are.
Why would we stop at one maid outfit when we can have...
Two.
Okay, you know what? I accept this.
She looks like a maid.
Well, yeah, it's kind of easy to look like a maid if you're in a maid outfit.
Yeah. I'm just saying, they're just like, yeah, she looks like a maid.
Oh, drum roll,
boy,
please.
Here we go.
Not at all.
Come on, Joshua.
You're just making this take longer.
I gotta pan the camera.
sparkles. Hell the fucking, yes.
The fucking sparkles.
What a beautiful baby boy. I mean, girl.
Don't call him a baby. Makes it weird.
Alright, enough fun. Let's, I don't know, go talk to some shitty guards. See if we can talk to the queen or some shit.
Shut up, Estelle.
Well, excuse me.
Yeah, come on.
Wait a minute. Uh-huh. I just had a dark revelation.
What?
Joshua's in a maid outfit.
Yeah. Hurry up, the video's almost over.
He uses double short swords. And sure. he has moves that let him, like, phase in and out. Is he Sakuya? Sure.
No.
He's a Toho character. Next time.